I'm Dr. Karen Hildebrand with AWS.
I'm Kunal Patil with Glidewell Laboratories, and this is My Architecture.
Dental work sounds fairly personal. Can you tell me a little bit about what that means at an individual level?
Sure, yeah. So talking about restorations, we make like several million restorations a year, and each restoration is unique. So that means we produce lot one size.
Let's get started with AWS IoT Core.
Sure, this is the central place. And in our architecture, we have like a bunch of machines. Those are connected with the IoT Core. There are approximately 40 mills. Those are connected over here. And then we also have something like apps from which we get the data. And those are approximately 20 machines.
Great. And so as that data is flowing through, how many messages would be going into the queues that you have here?
So we scale it down to about 1 million a day.
Okay. You have two different queues. And my understanding is that you have a job queue and an overall equipment effectiveness queue. Tell me a little bit about the data that flows through there, and then we'll get into the statistics service.
Sure. So the job queue is nothing but getting the job data from two different sources. One is IoT Core, so all my devices, and one is all the apps. What it does, it takes the job data and then puts it into this database. The OEE is nothing but all the machine data that flows from the core into this database.
All right, so you have all the telemetry that you're capturing on the jobs and the machines, and it comes into the brain. Tell us a little bit about what the brain is thinking and what you've really designed your statistical service to do.
Yeah, so this is a statistical service. What it does, it basically find out the granular statistics about the machine, about the app, about the people, and everything, right? We also have data source, we call it, which is S3, that we store all the evals that we receive from our dentist. And what we do is we look through that S3, get those evals, and put them in the database. We kind of get all this data from the rest of the two database and then save in the statistic database.
So the statistics database then is really determining kind of your thresholds, your levels where actions are taken. And you've talked a little bit about how those actions can be taken both at the machine level and out to your employee base. Do you want to start with maybe how you notify the rest of your team members based on what the statistical service is observing?
Yeah, so what does it do is it basically get all that data, and then it looks back how my machines were doing, how my devices were doing, and monitor it. And then there are built-in thresholds where we say if a particular device or particular machine is not doing well, then we kind of notify different people, right? So there are two notification services. One is we notify supervisors and managers through emails, and we also have like Teams channel where there are support people, supervisors, operators, right? And then we notify them as well, hey, you know what, this particular device is not doing good or it is down.
And you've also talked about not only notifying your team based on those thresholds being exceeded, but how you can actually have a control within IoT Core based on what's being observed in the statistical service in order for the mills to self-heal or to address that issue themselves. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. For that, the statistical service and we have ticketing service, they go hand in hand. So when the statistical service kind of sees if a there is a trend of a machine that's not doing well, it will basically send or command that machine through IoT Core to either run a calibration block and then see whether that machine is performing good. If not, then take down that machine and create tickets through a third-party ticketing service.
So you have real-time mechanisms in place for being able to help the machine recalibrate itself, monitor if it's solving that problem, escalate if needed, determine over time. Those are all real-time mechanisms. You've also got a dashboarding component that looks like all of this data that has been collected, you could look at it over time. Can you tell us a little bit about why you designed that?
Yeah, so the dashboards are completely proprietary. So what happens is since this is a very new architecture, manufacturing line, which is extremely complicated, even some of our executives did not know what to look for. So we are very flexible with this architecture, providing them whatever analytics and then turning them in a few days.
That's great. It allows people to interrogate the data, but not necessarily know their questions up front in this structure.
Yes.
So tell me, you originally said your challenge was you were at 3,400 lot size one a day, and you wanted to get to 4,000. Mm-hmm. Now that you have this architecture implemented, what does that look like now?
So we are able to hit our goal now. It's like 4,000 units. In fact, recently we hit our mark 4,000 in 21.5 hours.
That's a fantastic improvement. Thank you for sharing your architecture with us today.
It was my pleasure. Thank you so much.